Thing is, I see this more often than I wish to see it. I see people who, I'm telling you, God works in their life and God makes a change and God lays down the path. Step one, step two, step three, step four. He's got it all laid out for them and everything is set for them to live a new life, a changed life, a transformed life, an amazing life. But there's only one thing missing. That person doesn't believe it's possible. That person can't believe that I can be anything different than what I've always been. That person can't believe that my sinfulness, that can somehow just go away, that I can be a new creation in Christ. Come on. Come on, let's be real. That stuff is just, that isn't real talk. That may apply to Samaritan woman. That applies to like Levi. That applies to people in the Old Testament, but come on. Let's be practical right now. There's no practical in faith. All right? There's no common sense in faith. Faith says God wants to make a change, God can make a change, and God will make a change. And your job is not to do nothing. Just believe. Just don't get in his way, because the one thing that blocks him is your unbelief. It isn't God's fault that I couldn't change. It isn't God's fault that my life couldn't be new. I'm telling you, God wants to make it new and God is able. If there's a problem, it's your fault. And 99% of the time, the problem is that you didn't really believe. You didn't really have the faith that your life could be different. So as soon as you got scared, you said, I don't know what's going to happen, you run back to the old way of doing things. What I'm saying is that God has already raised you up and you must have the faith that believes it and continues to act on it, doing those things that God is there. Again, forget about this idea of sense. Who cares about sense? Sense says the dead don't rise. Faith says dead can rise. Sense says that you may have been the same for a million years and you can never change. Faith says you can change today. Sense says that sin is part of me and I've always sinned and I'm a bad person and sin is part of my nature. Faith says that behold, all things are new, and when you are in Christ, those are a new creation. Old things have passed away. So what I'm going to tell you is, don't listen to sense. Sense doesn't know what he's talking about. All right? Sense is the one who told Jesus that he couldn't rise again. Sense is the one who said, I won't believe. Forget about sense. Like the stars, there's a beautiful verse in Luke chapter 18, verse 27. It says very simply that the things that are impossible for me and for you, Thomas, and for everyone, those things that you say is impossible to be done, with God, all things are possible. There's nothing that's impossible. So the lesson that he's trying to tell him right here is this applies to everything in life. Don't limit me to what you can see. Don't limit me to what you think I can do, because I can do much greater things. Our problem is in life is that we like to set limits for God. And when you have faith, there's no limits. So stop trying to set limits for God. Stop trying to tell God what he can do and he can't do. He's trying to tell you, I can make your life different like you've never seen. And the question and the challenge that I have for you is do you believe that or don't you believe? Do you believe? Do you have that faith? And do you believe that God can make something special? Or your faith is limited to the way it was before is the way it's going to go back and it's never going to change forever.